Let's see.
and see what
Oh
we're dealing
yeah.
with here.
Oh, that's cool. You can see the beam behind this door. See
Whoa,
It's pretty
holy crap.
good, right?
You
Look at
guys
that
don't even
lonely
want to
house over
know. You don't even want to know what's out
there.
there, man. That's the wildest thing ever. I will say though, this is one of the best barns, as Reggie said, that I've ever seen and been inside. And I've been in a lot of barns. I mean, I don't
You
know about
have.
you, Reggie, but yeah, I've been in a lot of barns. Like, I majored in barns, just in general, just the act of barns, the construction and placement of them. And I gotta say, this is in at
What?
least this is a 703 level
So you're
barn. That's
703,
barn.
703.
Yeah,
No,
that's
no.
barn
But I
talk,
mean,
but
also you
it
gotta
was
realize
talking.
that, like, that over here, I mean, you don't get this kind of an angle. You see the slope on this roof, which is really good for snowfall. You're not gonna get a lot of buildup, and you can get like
Disperses the
the.
weight.
Exactly. So that's a huge deal. Also, I don't know if you guys are familiar. I don't know if you can. I don't think we can get up here. I've been trying to get up here for a long time, but. Oh, okay. Hey,
Oh
Bales.
my
Hey,
goodness.
Bales. Don't dream it's over. Hold on. I'm trying. How do you get
This
up here? Oh,
is
how'd you do
yeah,
that?
this
Where'd
is
you? Where are
where
you?
this is
Pumpkin? I love that. That's the answer. Pumpkin. Just pumpkin.
Pumpkin.
Oh, aim for
Oh
the pumpkin.
shoot.
Oh, yeah. Oh, okay, cool. All right. Well,
Yeah, you
this is
know.
one of the. This is so spooky. There we go. So we're gonna take a quick look
Reggie,
out here.
Reggie, Reggie, this is actually interesting, the part of the barn that we're in now, because I don't know if you guys know this, but this is usually the area of the barn where the barn owls will build their little nests and lay
That's
barn owl
true.
eggs. Yeah,
That's
so
true. Yep.
that's a true
That's
thing.
so cool. Look at
Ooh.
these two guys,
Yeah.
just nicely framed in these windows up here. That's where owls usually hang out, and they're kind of representing
That's where they
Owl
fly.
possibilities. That's where they fly. They are making eggs right now. If there are any ladies over there, they're probably making eggs right now.
Yeah, those windows are.
They're nice. I don't know how people get up there, but
Hey, listen, if I was an owl, I wouldn't be complaining.
I know, I wouldn't be complaining. This is a nice barn, man, I have to say. I mean, I think we could just talk about how nice this barn is the whole time. I mean, it's incredible. Also, the light work and the shading, the polygons. I mean, come on. Look at
Come
this.
on, get out of here
Look
with these
at
polygons. Get out of here with these
that.
polygons. Are you kidding
I
me?
can't. I'm
This is
trying to not kid
crazy.
you.
I'm
Can you
like,
be
are
in
you
the.
serious? I'm looking at these polygons and I'm like, are you joking with me with these polygons? These are incredible.
These are
This
the
is
best
some polygon
polygons.
work. I mean,
But I
the
mean.
poly I last time I saw a polygon this good, I can't even tell you. I was a little wee lad. I was this high. I
How
was
high?
this high. I was the size of this pumpkin. See? I was about this high when I saw the first polygon that was this even close to as good as this.
Like around there,
Yeah, it was about this
about that
somewhere in that neighborhood.
Yeah, right there. I mean, it's rough. It's rough. That's great. That's great. That's so awesome. Yeah, I mean, I was probably like, let's see, let's talk to Jesse over here. I guess I was probably like, maybe like that. Like that. Or no,
Okay.
sorry.
Yeah.
Like that. That's where I was at
Yeah.
when I first discovered polygons, because you're a lot younger than I am. So I was at that.
You're about right there.
There, right there.
Right there. Okay.
Yeah,
Yeah, I can
right
see
there.
that. That's good. That's a good time to. That's a good age to like
Discover it, man.
get a good polygon look. Yeah.
Yeah, totally.
So,
Oh, yeah. So, you
hey,
want to
what are you
talk
gonna
about
talk
your,
about?
you want to talk
Yeah,
about
go.
your, you were talk, you had a mushroom trip.
Yeah.
Want to talk about your mushroom trip?
Yeah. So, well, I mean, we could talk about that. We might as well. Like,
Let's start
well, I
things
was just gonna
off.
ask. Well, I was gonna ask before we get into the mushroom trip thing, because that is an interesting tale. It happened just this last Saturday, so we'll tease that. But we also, I also have a question for the room, for everyone. What do you all think about the Nintendo Switch?
Yeah.
Excited?
Oh, look. Yeah.
Do you hear the silence of joy?
Yeah.
It's not VR. I heard a fart noise.
True.
Yeah.
Skyrim, yeah. Oh, man, that's true.
All right, well, listen, okay. I just want to know what you thought. I don't know. Am I going to buy stock or not? I don't know. Probably not. Maybe.
You know, I like the idea of the Switch. Huh? Oh.
Oh.
Sorry, that's right. We keep forgetting about that. Sorry.
Yeah. No.
Don't ruin it. Include everybody. You're the included.
So here's how you buy. If you want to buy Nintendo stock right now for the Nintendo right Switch, look down and there should be a little control button on the bottom. You should see it. You see the little alt-space control button?
Everybody.
All you have to do is control alt delete your System 32 folder, and you'll buy stock in Nintendo. That's how it works.
And it's so easy. We made it as easy as possible.
How do I climb up there?
Yeah. Right. Although. Exactly. Thank you. Jesus, someone who can finally speak common person. So if you really want to buy into Nintendo, now is the time. So switch it out.
You've
got Squanchtendo. Are you gonna create any peripherals, any devices for Squanchtendo?
I hope so one of these days. I want a peripheral where it's like a big giant egg shell. Like from Mork's son, what was his name? Jonathan Winters.
Jonathan Winters.
Jonathan Winters. Yeah, so just a giant eggshell, and then you get inside of it like Jonathan Winters did, and then that's the peripheral that I want to make, but nobody's so cool. Interested.
You know what would be really cool is what if it always stayed to your side, and that way it'd be a real peripheral?
Yeah, it's just like tied to your like a rope just connecting you everywhere you go.
Yeah, no matter where you look, it's always just like right here. that's real.
These are the kinds of things we want to bring to the masses.
Absolutely.
Very important.
Nice high five over there.
So you want to go back to the
Let's go back to the designated area.
Let's go back to here. Let's go back to one.
All right.
G.I. Joe! Okay.
Back to one, ladies and gentlemen.
Come on, let's take that again.
Again from one?
Watch this Tokyo
Drift. How are you doing that? Oh, I think it's because...
I'm Tokyo Drifting. You only have one controller, brah.
Yeah,
can I have the second controller?
I need it. I need my
other
controller.
Don't you have a support team? Just so you guys know, there's like a support team of 18 people in each of our houses.
That's true. Will the second controller...
Watch this controller appear out of nowhere and land in his hand. Watch this. Look at that.
Yeah, watch. Almost. Get ready. Watch.
She's trying to give you hers. Look at that.
Oh, jeez. Oh, that's not... Mine looks like Pikachu. You can't see it, but... Is there another...
Look at that. Look! Your controller's there. Where's your controller? Where's your support team?
They're readying my other controller.
That's it. That really is it.
Oh, my God. That is it.
That really is it.
Okay, wait. Oh,
I hope it hovers above your hand. Yeah, there you go. Now try drift.
Tokyo
Drift. There we go.
Wow, that's weird. All right, now we're two controlling it.
All right.
So do you want to hear? Should we talk about my weird shroom experience this weekend?
Yeah, let's talk about. Guys, you guys want to hear of a shroom experience? Even the people we can't see.
I know, man.
Yeah, and.
Yeah, Mojing.
It's like a bunch of thumbs down.
It looks like they don't. They don't. Okay. Well, let's talk about cafeterias.
I love cafeterias.
So do I.
They're so clean and nice. Well, I guess this is an anticlimactic. Reggie, please, you can ask me questions as I continue through the tale. But so I had a little bit to drink, and I ate a little bit of weed chocolate, and I thought it would be a good idea. I was like, hey, I think this would be a good idea for me to eat this shroom chocolate I have, which I had. At the time I had it, now I no longer have it because I ate it on Saturday. And I ate it, and I was like, hey, this is going to be great. I'm just gonna experience this, and, you know, it'll be fun. And then I realized it was 4 in the morning, and I was like, oh, that's not good. I didn't know it was that late. Mm-hmm. And I go and I lay in bed, and Abby, where's Abby at? She's in real world with Abby. Me next to me somewhere.
Abby, in-world.
Where, yeah. Abby? In-world. Abby's in-world somewhere, in real world. And I'm laying in bed, and I'm like, I'm panicking because I'm seeing things, you know, how mushrooms tend to make you see things. And I'm thinking, yep. I'm very melty, and I'm just like kind of like melting into the bed. And I was like, oh my God, I was so tired. And I was like, oh my goodness, I feel like if I fall asleep, I could maybe die in my sleep, but I'm so tired. What if I fall asleep and like I suffocate to death? So I'm in bed at the peak of this shroom, this horrible mistake that I took these shrooms, and I'm laying in bed, and then I'm just like melting into the bed, and then I wake Abby up, who also has had, you know, plenty to drink and smoke herself of weed. And I'm like, hey, listen to me. I'm shaking her. Here, you be her. I'm like, hey, come here. Listen to me. Hey, you gotta.
What?
Listen.
Honey,
you gotta keep an eye on me. Keep an eye on me because I'm drifting off to sleep. Mm-hmm. And I'm worried that if I cross into sleep, I may never come back. This could be it. I may never come back to this, to the mortal world. So just keep an eye on me, will you? Like, if you hear me choking or not breathing clearly. Okay.
Sure.
Okay, and then I kind of rolled back and on my back, which is not a good, you know, you should really lay on your side if you're worried about suffocating in your sleep. So that's a tip for all the kids out there. Lay on your side if you're worried. If you're drifting off into sleep, you're worried you might suffocate to death. And then I fell asleep and I woke up the next day. I was fine. So can I get a round of applause for that little tale? Huh? Whoa, maybe. Whoa, baby. Yeah. Let's get a round of applause for that tale. That's an educationary tale. It's a cautionary tale. It's like a tale that says, hey, learn from me. Don't do as I do. Don't, you know, right?
Just don't.
I woke up. I managed to wake up. I don't remember. I have no recollection of any of what my dreams were. It was kind of just a big, just all of a sudden I was awake the next day. That's how it happened. I know.
And there was no mushrooms in it, and I was like, ah, fuck. that sucked. Yeah.
I'll be the person you woke up in the middle of the night.
Okay.
Go ahead. Yeah.
Hey.
What?
Wake up, what? Honey. Sugar pants, crunchy puffs.
What's up, sweetie?
I took mushrooms. I took mushrooms before I took a nap, and I don't feel mushrooms at all. I'm really bummed.
Oh my goodness. Okay. Well, I'm gonna keep an eye. I'm gonna sit up. I'm gonna sit round the clock. I'm gonna watch you. I'm gonna keep an eye on you. Absolutely.
Just make sure that I do get high somehow.
You're gonna be okay.
Okay.
You're gonna be okay.
I'm,
Oh my God! Wake up, sweetie! Wake up, sweetie! Wake up, sweetie!
Am I
wake
high? Up. Am I high you're... yet? Am I high yet?
Are you? Are you high? High?
I don't feel the mushrooms. I'm asking you. I don't feel any. I don't see any.
I think you're very high right now on the mushrooms.
What? Oh shit.
No, you're not. No, you're fine. You
okay,
were just
I'm
snoring.
Not. Okay, I'm not.
You
okay,
were just
sorry,
snoring. You were just snoring.
Okay,
yeah.
Sorry.
That was Belgium chocolate. God. That was just regular Belgium chocolate from Belgium.
It was really good. It was really good. Did you know that Belgium refused to sign on to the Canadian trade deal agreement?
I didn't know this.
Okay,
that upsets me. How dare they?
Yeah, I know.
How dare they do this thing?
I know. No, I did take mushrooms once, and I had a good time. But I remember I was in a forest. I was in a forest, and or you know what? Virtual insanity is what we're living in.
Wait, no, yeah, you were in a forest.
I was in a forest, and I was in my friend's lap. Like, she was cross-legged, and I was, like, had my head in her lap. And I was hearing her breathing, and we were under this huge tree in the Arboretum in Seattle. And I could hear her breathing, and I went on this journey, like, into the sacred female. It was like I went into this like crazy kaleidoscopic, like super ultra universal feminine vibe. It was really, really cool. And then I came out of it and I was like crying and stuff. And she was like, "What's going on?" I was like, "I don't know." She's like, "I think I know." And I was like, "Yeah, that's cool. That was, yeah." And then I went into a bathroom that happened to be open in the park. And I sat on a toilet and I put my head in my hands. And I was just like sitting on the toilet. I wasn't doing anything other than that. And then
yeah, grossies,
I just
grossos. Streaming.
Yeah, sorry, sorry, just normsies.
Yeah, sorry to do.
toilet seat. It's just a seat at that point. Just sitting on a toilet, but and not even the right way. But anyways, I basically met myself, non-self. It was really cool, and I was like, ah, there you are. It's been a long time. That was kind of it.
Nice.
Whoa, jeez, that's insane. That is insane. Can we get a round of applause for that? Because, like, I haven't had that happen. I haven't met my non-self. Although I did eat weed chocolate earlier, and I was having a panic attack about being in VR in front of people, so there's that.
I took a weed pill just before going on.
What?
I took a weed pill, guys. I took a pill.
Jealous.
How many of you guys that we can see, we know that there are other beings in the other universes that we can't see, but how many of you guys took some weeds?
I got some weed.
Okay. That looks like it's about 60-70%. Turns out VR people, you know, they know how to do it right.
By the way, you know, I take it for medicinal reasons, you know, like,
so do
you
I.
Know, I have ADD.
Yeah.
Right? There we go. Everybody.
I have ad. Why doesn't anyone call
ad?
They should. Oh. I they have.
Should. Guys, I
have
ad.
ADD and it sucks ass.
Sucks ass.
I have ADD and it
Why
sucks
do
the ass.
I have ad?
Why do I have
ad? Do you suffer
ad?
From ad? before I forget, let's talk about your VR game. Oh,
shit. You have the tiniest feet
accounting?
I've ever seen.
Accounting.
Oh, jeez. Have you guys all tried?
Look at those little feet.
accounting is crows, and Squanchtendo. I don't know if you guys have ever played the Stanley Parable or Dr. Langeskov.
Yes.
Yeah.
Anybody? Yeah, I see a lot of hands and hearts.
Yeah, I've played one of them.
So I worked with William Pugh on that, and his comrade Dom, and those guys are like heroes to me. Like, they're just geniuses, and it was just like this crazy game jam. We got together and made this insane experience. Did you try it, Reggie? Did you get a chance, or was it kind of?
Oh shit! No, I didn't get back home soon enough.
Reggie played the first half of the game, pretty much. I would say, yeah, probably every and back in during PAX West, yeah, or Bumper,
yep,
Shoot.
Yep.
Reggie and I hung out in real life,
in real world,
you know, real space,
meat space,
and
space.
And we run amok at the Valve offices, and I put him in an early build of accounting, and I remember your big note was like, can you make the xylophone with the skeleton bones a little more responsive? And I was like, I hope so. I hope we can. I was like, I hope we can do that.
Yeah. Did you?
But yeah. I think it's still got a little bit of a lag. Yeah, it's like a little, but it's that's, you know, you look at the key pillars. What are the key pillars of the game? Is it a music xylophone game? No.
I think it is.
The point of the game is get to that part and fucking write music. Start writing music. That is where you are going to begin your musical career.
Exactly.
Musical.
Yeah, I like musicianal.
Yeah. Musicianal is a good word. Can we call Webster? Too. And I'm not talking about the show, the kid on the show. I'm talking about the dictionary people.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, he had the secret pet Webster. Yeah. He had the crazy book, or the grandfather clock.
Yeah, the grandfather clock.
Dude, the dumb waiter. I mean, I grew up and I'm like, where's my secret passageways, Dad?
I know.
And it was like, you know, and he was like, get out of my face, a little rapscallion. My dad, Reggie, lied to me when I was very young, because I was begging him for this little tiny battery-powered Pac-Man game. It was like, you know, this has had to have been early or mid-80s. And I was begging him for it. And he said, it reminds me of the old Calvin and Hobbes strips. He basically said, yeah, no, up in the attic above your bedroom, there's a whole toy store up there. All those things are up there. Everything you and you know, and he took me to Toys R Us, and he walks me through Toys R Us, and he's showing me, he's like that's upstairs, that's in the attic, all this stuff, everything you see all is in the attic. And
what?
I believed him, and then I remember it got to the point where I was bawling, I was sobbing, I was like, please, I want to go in the attic, please. Why can't we go in the attic? Why can't we see all these toys? And I had this vision in my head of this incredible, like, just fully packed, like, toy store up there. Despite, you know, you go outside and look at our house, it's like there's no room, you know, it's like, it doesn't make, I'm a child, I'm a baby, though, I'm a kid. I don't know. And then my mom finally had to come out and go, enough, there's no toy store up there. She had to rip the bandage of truth off. Or the bandage of lies, I guess, off. It's not real! Do you want to see? Yeah, of course I did. Yeah, of course I did. I'm lucky I'm still alive. I probably could have died up there trying to find the toys.
Did your dad lie to you a lot?
There was rat traps up there. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Here's another one he did. Do you guys remember the movie Invaders from Mars, the 1996 remake? This is a deep cut, so it's fine if you don't. You saw it? Okay. It's really, if you haven't seen it, it's, no. Invaders from Mars, it's the 1986. Jesus Christ. 1986 yeah, movie. Please, everyone make mental note. Watch it this Halloween season. It's worth it. It's great. It's campy, but it's an amazing, awesome, fun movie. So in the movie, it's a kid protagonist, and, you know, he's seeing that aliens are basically taking over, and, you know, it's a Body Snatchers type thing. And they all have these little tiny band-aids on the back, just right on the back of the neck, right there. You see where I'm rubbing you? Right there. Right on the back of the neck, they have those little tiny band-aids. And those band-aids would hide where they drilled in this thing into the person's neck. And my dad, I'm 6 years old. I was born in '80, so I'm 6 years old. My dad takes me to the theater to see this, and then I'm scared. I'm freaked out. And then what does he do? He gets my mom. He puts one of those exact same band-aids on the back of my mom's neck, and then comes and gets me. And he's like, "Hey, Justin, oh my God, something's wrong with your mom. Something's wrong with your mom. Come here." And he wasn't all crippled like I look right now. My dad's not all crippled and. He's not all crippled and weird like this. He was normally abled. Not that there's anything wrong with being crippled. That's like, I am, God bless you. Like, I will donate money. I'm the most. I have so much empathy for like the you know everything. So he's like, come here, Justin, come here. Something's wrong with your mom. You need to come see. And then she's in the bathroom, and he told my mother to act like weird and drool and zombie-ish, and I just had a full-on like I flipped fuck out. And then they had to just go, no, we're just fucking with you. You're 6 years old, it's fine. No, here, look, take it off. My mom's name is Becky. Becky, take it off. Look, she's fine. I'm sobbing. And I said, we're just kidding. And then here's what they said. This is my what is it called? Condolence prize?
Oh, condolence.
What is it called?
Consolation.
Consolation.
There you go. I knew it was a C word. So here's your consolation prize. I went to a daycare at the time. They said, here, why don't you wear one of these sticks? Why don't you go to the daycare and wear one of these bandages on the back of your neck and freak out all the kids there? And I'm like, and I did it, and I got through half the day before I realized none of these fucking kids saw this movie. I'm sick. This is a rated R horror movie. I'm six. This is not a condolence. Wait, I got it wrong again. Condolence.
Consolation.
This is under no circumstances. It's a consolation for what you've done to me, Mom and Dad. You're
crazy.
Monsters. And those are the things that shaped my adult mind, I feel like.
That's kind of amazing. I mean, if you think about it, I mean, that's kind of like activating your imagination where it bleeds into reality in that way.
Yes.
It kind of like it does open up your mind in a way, because once you realize that they were fucking with you, that like that informs you that you can do a version of that, you know, for yourself, to your friends or whatever. You know, so I don't know.
Go ahead.
No, you go.
This is where we do our no, you go ahead bit. What is like the rest of the show? What am I, Marty Scorsese? Scazy over here? You go. Get it? That's a deep one. What am I, Marty Scorsese? You go.
Hey, you go. What am I, Francis Ford, winemaker?
Oh my God, that is scary to do. By the way, that's horrifying. What you're doing? You're gonna hurt everybody.
Let's see. Hey guys.
Oh my God. Oh my God, that's horrifying. Okay.
I can do. Anyways, I was. When did you first start like drawing and shit and making weird voices and stuff?
My first word was "fuck you, America." No, I'm just kidding. By the way, there was no political agenda there. I don't know why I said that, but I don't know. I feel like I was drawing, like, my mom used to describe pains in her stomach, like a weird sharp pain. And when I came out, I had a number two pencil sharpened, and I had all these little drawings. And the doctor was like, this is incredible. And the doctor was just like, I've never seen anything like this before. And they, they were going to call the X-Files people, you know. Right.
Yeah.
They were gonna call him in, and it was gonna be an episode of X-Files, and then the people at Fox were like, I guess the head writer of X-Files was like, nope, not gonna happen on my watch, because this isn't Law and Order SVU unit. You know what I mean?
Wait a minute. So you're saying since you were born, that you've been involved somehow, peripherally or happenstantially, in the television industry, like immediately.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. What's the guy that you guys refresh my memory? I know his name. I mean, but like the guy that created X-Files, what's that guy's name again? Anyone?
Hank.
Come on.
Chris
Carter. Chris Carter slapped the contract. So when my mother and father were filling out my birth certificate, trying to figure out what they were going to call me, they also had a contract for the rights of my story to be a potential X-Files episode once that show got into development many years later in the future. And Chris Carter ran in the room and knocked it on the ground, and then this is what he did to it. Imagine, like, imagine it's right here. You guys see that? Imagine it's right, this is the contract right here. That's what he did.
A point right there.
And he said, no, I don't think so. This isn't what X-Files is about. This isn't about X-Files. This isn't what X-Files is. No.
Right here.
No. No.
And this is the contract.
Get out of here. No. And then he did this, and then he did this. I don't know if you guys can see my feet, but then he did this.
Check
he kind of went
guys.
Like this. He did this. He kind of like, he ripped it up. He like, he would, he stepped on one side, and then he used the other side to rip.
Oh.
And it was a lot of work. It was a lot of work. But he kept his hands free the whole time. His hands were free. They were just up here as he ripped the contract up like this.
That's so crazy, man.
Yeah.
That's so that's insane. So you lost an opportunity to be a part of the X-Files family.
Huge opportunity. I would have been a main character.
Yeah.
A kid who drew a drawing in his mother's fetus, or in his mother's stomach, I mean.
His mother's fetus, yes. You know, there's someone inside the fetus controlling it. So, so
the drawing. Somebody asked, "What was the drawing?" Well, I'll tell you.
Yeah.
It was a drawing of that weird bell thing that Hitler allegedly escaped at the end of World War II.
The time machine.
Yeah, the time machine. That's what it was a drawing of. Now, if that's not X-Files material, then I don't know, you know, what Chris Carter's thinking. But he ripped that thing up. Yeah. Oh, wait. Hold on. I see a hand in the air. How does that work again? There's the... Yeah, I see all these hands. I'm told if we click on
a
hand.
To click on them? Click on it. Like, do you click on the circle or the hand?
Let's just, I'm going to click on the circle and see what happens.
Click on the, just click on it.
Oh, it's Stranger.
It. I clicked on it. Does...
Okay.
Oh, Stranger. And Memer.
Oh, hey.
Memer's in here.
Go ahead, Stranger.
Look, hey, Justin, I was wondering, are you going to be on season 2 of Harmon Quest? Because I feel like you got a lot to offer there.
Oh, I would love to. I love board games. I haven't been asked, but like Harmon and I are buddies. I'll talk to him about it tomorrow. I'm gonna be with him tomorrow.
I want to do it too.
I'll tell him. But can we Please. Right here? We have to create a pact. Only if we're together. Only if he puts us in together. Oh, all right, here we go. There we go. It's a virtual pact. Did a virtual pact.
Thanks, man.
Yeah.
All right. How about Memer?
Let me
Memer.
Memer.
Memer. Memer.
No, Memer's Memer. Here. I've got a big
Memer. Unmute Memer. 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 Memer.
My name is Memer.
Oh, can I there go ahead and ask you guys? I had to stand up for this one. Can we count on your vote for Donald J. Trump this coming election?
Ooh. Oh man!
What do you think?
Now I've heard about these.
You're right.
I heard about
right.
these.
That is exactly what I expected.
I don't know if you've heard Reggie about these things called politics. They're called politics. Do they bite?
Ticks.
Do they bite? Like, do they cause Lyme disease like the other ones? I know there's or are they like poly? Are they poly in the sense that they're like, you know, polyamorous and they sort of they're the kind of ticks that sort of just, you know, like, you know, they have many lovers. They you can't hold me down. I'm a polyamorous. I'm a poly tick.
Yeah.
I'm a poly tick.
No, I mean, that's what it is. Poly ticks, and they can give you either Lyme's disease or Lemon's disease. It's like all the diseases.
Strawberries disease.
Yeah.
Strawberries puree
asses.
Disease.
Yes.
Yeah.
A lot of sibilants. But I mean, I think it's safe to say that I'm definitely, you know, going to be here. So, you know, we can check it out.
I really want to, what I want to make sure is that to make sure everyone knows that we know a lot of things about ticks, Lyme disease, politics. We know a lot about politics, But we also just want to say that they're not as bad, according to what I've read on the internet, as bed bugs. Bed bugs are apparently really worse than poly ticks.
No, those are gross. No. Yeah. And then I would suggest putting a mattress cover, a mattress protector. That'll make it harder for bed bugs infestations.
That's right.
How about Viaria? Viaria.
Viaria. Okay.
Hi, guys. Viaria. So, Justin, I have a question for you. Are you ever going to... Are you ever going to finish your two Girls, One Cup series?
I mean, I feel like it's kind of finished, isn't it? I mean, were you imagining more episodes of like, where does this character go from here?
I guess
never say never, but never say never, but yeah, maybe good old Cup will come back and have a bunch of crazy fun adventures.
That would be great,
man. I think it's a great, you know, this reminds me of, I have a friend called the DGJ, and the DGJ has amazing questions. You should check it out. Go ahead.
Yes.
The DGJ.
The DGJ.
How'd you get up there?
So Rick and Morty season 3.
Oh, look, DGJ's got moving arms.
Yeah.
He's got moving arms, and he's doing all kinds of moving arm positions. That's pretty
great.
It's
a custom avatar. Look at that custom avatar, guys.
He's also standing on a platform.
Yeah, you've got like lifter, like a lift kit.
Yeah, he's got a dual overhead kit. He's got a lift kit.
That's
pretty fantastic.
Will Reggie Watts have a role in the upcoming season of Rick and Morty? Because he needs one.
Here's what I will say. All I can say is that eventually. You know what I'm saying? Eventually.
We need a planet of Reggie Watts.
Eventually, yo. Yeah.
It's in my contract.
I like that. Yeah, it's in his contract. Oh, C-3PO. I mean, I'm C-3PO. R2. R2-D2. R2, hurry. Hurry, R2. R2, we have to get out of here. This is dangerous. R2, this is dangerous here. R2, come back. R2!
R2!
Can I ask you some questions, R2?
Sure, beep.
What is your favorite thing about the Star Wars world you live in?
Oh, beep, beep, beep. Beep, boop, beep, 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 boop, beep, beep, beep.
This...
beep, 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 beep.
Now that's
beep,
an answer beep. You can take home to Mom! Boop, beep, give it up for R2-D2!
Boop, beep, beep, beep. See you guys. Bye.
Give it up for R2!
Hey guys, what's up? Hey guys, I was just outside the outhouse. Did anything cool happen?
Yeah, Reggie, R2-D2 is here. R2-D2 showed up.
R2-D2?
Yeah, I know how much you love him. I'm sorry that you have missed him. He's like...
You guys dodging me?
No, Reggie talks about R2-D2 all the time, and that's so sad that you weren't here to meet him. He did say hi to you, though. He said, in his own way, he said, please tell Reggie I said hello, and that I'm getting my degree in, he's going to some kind of medical school thing he was talking about, so it's exciting for
cool.
him.
He took my advice. We were pen pals, I just never met him. That's cool.
Yeah.
Anyway, so let's keep talking about technology. Let's take some questions. Let's get some alternate unit. Oh, how'd you do that? That was really good.
Let's see. See that again. Do that. I have to do that. Was it just one? Oh, what are you doing now?
I don't know what's happening.
Okay, let's see. Let's take a question. I'm going to take one from this hand. It's a random hand. Let's see.
It's a random hand.
Like, oh, classic. Ladies and gentlemen. This is my friend. Guest 861-7965.
Ah, of guest course. We got to love Guest 865. They know who they are.
They have a microphone, do they?
Hey,
Guest 861-7965.
Yes, yeah, yes, we hear you. Guest.
Oh, okay.
First time visitor?
Okay. Yes. So in Rick and Morty season one commentary, the first two episodes, you guys would like bust out into rap like all the time, and it was like a lot looser feel. Like, did you guys stop because standards and practices, or like what made you guys stop?
Wait, do you mean in respect to the season two commentary, or?
Yeah, it was like a lot more structured.
There's an easy answer for that. And when we recorded the season one commentary, we got drunk. And when we did the season two commentary, we were a little more sober and like in the middle of working. That's the most boring but true answer, I think.
Okay.
We have an incoming question from Valent. Valent, unmute your microphone and present a question.
Okay, thank you so much, guys. Gotta say, I'm a huge fan. I don't have a question. All I want to see is whether or not you guys can seduce my wife real quick. Just say something sexy to her. That's all I ask.
We got a cuckold over here, ladies and gentlemen. We got a real
real cuckold. He's got a hold of his cuck. All right, hey, let's talk in private real quick.
Okay, that's fine. That's fine.
Let's talk in private real quick. What should we say?
Did I get it right?
I think you did.
Is that how it goes? It's like, you remember the McBLT? The McBLT song. That's what I thought.
Yeah.
You're
cool
welcome.
On the cool side, hot on the hot side. Hey, let's see. There's another question here, right over here. Let's see. Who is it? Let's see. Oh, God, this is a weird one. TRAVIS.
Hey, who is this?
Travis.
Sorry, Travis.
Hey.
Travis.
Hey. What do you have how's it going, guys?
My battery's dying.
Oh, so
hey,
I'm...
Travis.
How's it going, guys? I'm actually a...
Yeah.
I'm an AllSpace employee here at the office in Redwood City, California. Just want to say you guys hey. Justin, I got a really important question for you. So I believe you have Andy sitting next to you, right?
Andy? Yeah, where is he?
So I wanted to know.
Wait,
Andy should be there in your place, right? Like helping you run the event. Or Sam, Andy or Sam?
Sam.
Yeah. So could you do me a huge favor?
Sam.
Could you do me a huge favor?
Yeah. What do you want?
And could you just draw any monster that you can come up with, and I'll get it tattooed on my body tomorrow. And just give
it
to Sam.
Are you fucking serious?
Give it to Sam, and I'll get it tattooed on my body.
Will you tweet the image? Will you tweet the image at me, and
I
can retweet it?
Just please don't make it with a penis, and I'll do anything else. I swear on my life.
Okay. I'll keep it G-rated. It'll be G-rated.
Dude, I'm so excited.
I'll keep it PG-13. I'll keep it 80s PG-13.
Perfect.
That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about, brah.
You got the whole office laughing over here, guys. Thanks so much.
What do you guys...
Reggie,
I was going to ask the whole group, before we take the next question, have you guys all been watching a lot of scary movies because it's October time?
Yeah.
No.
Anybody? Count Dracula, great movie. Invaders from Mars, great one.
The 1986.
Mean Girls. Scanners. How about The Gate? Anybody
oh,
the for
Gate's
The Gate?
Great. I love The Gate.
I love The
I
Gate.
I love The Gate. Remember Gate 2 with the poo-poo?
I did.
Poo-poo money?
I didn't see, no, I didn't see
Gate 2. You never saw Gate 2? Oh, you gotta see Gate 2 with the poo-poo money. Oh,
man,
the Kyoto Brothers.
Oh my god.
The Kyoto Brothers.
Okay. All right. How about Mothman Prophecies? That's a good one.
Is it? I haven't seen that one. Oh, have you guys all seen The Mist? Frank Darabont?
I love The Mist.
It's so good, isn't it? If you're a fan of The Walking Dead, you should watch it.
Oh, by the way,
Frank Darabont.
You said Walking Dead. You said Walking Dead. How many saw the first episode of season 7?
Oh, God, don't. They're going to spoil it. They're going to spoil it.
No, there's nothing to spoil. I'm just saying, like, I sincerely mean this. Do not watch it. It's so depressing. It's the most depressing episode of television I've ever seen.
Well, now I have to watch it. To watch it.
Well, let's take a question from a ham-sized ham hand.
Whoa.
Okay. I'm taking from a hammed. Okay. Oh, it looks like we got another complicated one. We got payol.
Payol.
P-A-U-L.
Peel.
This question's for Reggie. What is your opinion of the Illuminati?
Oh, thanks. Hey.
What's your opinion of the Illuminati?
Oh, the Illuminati.
Yes.
Oh, the opinion of the Illuminati. Well, you know, I'd like to think it's a good board game, but I would say, you know, the Illuminati, you know, they're all right. I mean, they've never really done me wrong.
Hey, listen. We're on the list to get in, so we can't talk smack about them right now. We're about to get in.
That's actually true.
You're already in.
We're about to get in.
We want to make our way into that system and change that system from within.
Yeah, we.
You're in, Reggie.
Yep. I mean, like work my way in, and then
that's
just kind of work it.
It
in. Just kind of work it out.
I'll send you an invite.
You got to start from within.
Yeah. Well, so yeah.
Hey,
so, but to answer your question,
Payol.
I think it's good. It's good, Payol. Thank you, Payol. Thank you so much. I'm glad we got that. Photographs? Oh,
Twitter.
Let's
yeah.
Twitter quest.
Let's hear it.
Let's do it.
Oh, that's easy. Don't do this, though. Don't do that. I legally clarified, you shouldn't do this because I don't want to get sued. But the best way to die in VR, I would imagine, is to like just swallow a ton of some kind of really deadly pill, and then just go into like altered state or vanishing realms or something, and
what's
then just kind of go to the
vanishing realms.
Yeah, go to vanishing realms. Get to the forest, and then just lay on your back and look at the beautiful VR moon and drift off into a you know, the peaceful everlasting sleep. Now listen, I'm not telling you to do that. I'm just saying if one
That's
were
one
to that I feel, or you could also get tie a hose to your car exhaust, run it, snake it into your VR room. And then, like, you know, go into, and same thing,
plastic
go into Vanishing Realms.
plastic
up your windows.
Yeah.
Go into Vanishing Realms again. Go to the forest, lay on your back, and just drift off into a peaceful, blissful, ever after. What do you think?
Oh, you know what? Here's a fun way. If you get one of those Omen backpack computers for VR, and like, so you got backpacks, so you're completely untethered. Then go up in a plane and just jump out without a parachute. and just do a little.
God! If you could time it, you know. Oh my god! Okay, wait. Can I pitch on that? What if you say all the same parameters, but you boot up Windlands? Anyone play Windlands?
Uh-huh.
And then you go into a really tall building. You go into a really tall building, and you kind of like you take the head, you take your headset, you kind of make sure, okay, I'm right at the edge, and then you squeeze the triggers and jump off the building, and then time it so that when you actually hit the ground in VR, you will really hit the ground in real life. That's great. That's a good.
That's so cool.
You have one shot.
That's tops.
That's a good one. Right there.
That's a
but
good
it does
one.
Require, you know, you
one.
Have to have that computer. You have to have that computer with you to
Gotta have that backpack computer, guys.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Also the most recent update of Windows 10. So. So that's a good one. Complicated, but it's a good one. You get it running. It would suck if you glitched on the way down. You'd be like, no. Guys, let's take. Is there any more Twitter questions?
Yeah. Any more Twitter folk?
Are you want to find? You want us to take a regular question? You find a good one? Oh, okay, Gary.
Oh, I think that's coming. There's a program that they. Oh God, what is the name of it? There's a program that is literally
Mind Show.
Oh, Mind Show. There you go. Yep, you got it. No, I think that's what it's called. I swear to God. Yeah, Mind Show. Yeah, it's coming. It's coming. Mind Show. It's coming.
It's coming. Mind Show's cool. It's basically like what we're doing on stage. It's good. It's good. But you can record it. You can play it back. You create your own show.
There's also another.
Basically,
there's another one called like. Anything or any place? Anyone know that one? Any place? That's another one that's really neat. Any land.
What's it called?
Any land is another good one.
Oh,
any land.
Any land. It's actually Inland. Inland.
Inland. Inland. Yeah. Created by Inland. Evelyn. Evelyn created it.
Oh, you know what? I thought it was Evanescence, but it is Evelyn. Okay, cool. Guys, do we have any questions about Papa Roach or Better Than Ezra?
Yeah.
Okay, let's take this one. This one is another one of those weird ones. It's
Papa Roach.
Jamez.
Yeah, I'm glad you picked me. I've had this Papa Roach question for about a year and a half, and I was hoping that either of you could help me answer it.
Good.
We are the Papa Roach people.
On the last Papa Roach tour, we were, hanging out after the show, waiting for Steve to come out and, go to the tour bus.
Yeah.
And usually they don't talk to us, but they talk to us. And he'd mentioned both of you, actually. I had no idea that you guys followed them around on tour. You never said anything about that. What's going on there?
Well, I can tell you, two reasons. Reason number one, Pippi Longstocking. That's the first reason, and Reggie knows the other.
Pippi Longstocking, definitely a huge fan of very strong red-headed pigtail girls with secret treasure under their houses.
Yep.
But, the second reason...
Who are completely emancipated from any sort of parental, jurisdiction? Oversight?
Jurisdiction.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, oversight jurisdiction.
So the first part
is that we're huge, both of us, and this is why we kind of found each other. It's like Rick and Morty is like, I was like, oh, I got to check that out. I still got to check it out. No, I've checked it out. But anyways, but the thing that we really love together is we love grindcore. Like, we're huge fans of grindcore. And because of that, we just kind of came together and we found Papa Roach, and they're not totally grindcore, but they're kind of a new breed. So I just really liked them.
It's a new era of grindcore. It's a new era of like papas and roaches. And like, if you really know
a lot of
what
fathers.
It's about, there's a lot of papas, but and it's true.
Anti-rage. Yeah. It's the rage alternate. It was like, because everybody was like, Rage Against Machines. Forget it. I don't care.
Yeah, get out of my machine with that rage.
Yeah.
But I'll tell you that Papa Roach, the big thing they said is they're like, our next album title is called Pippi Longstockings. So that's why about that. Pippi Longstockings.
That's right. Yeah. That's why. Fuck, I forgot. Shit. Do we have any better than Ezra's questions?
Longstocking.
Pippi's, it's Pippi's logs because they were like, aren't we clever?
Pippi's with an apostrophe.
That was kinda cool.
Yeah. And then on the cover art, it's just a long stocking. It's just the most insane stocking. And then they're talking about merchandising, a really crazy stocking for the fans to buy. It's just it's unusable. It's so long, and there's only one, so it's like you can't even. I mean, I guess you could cut it in half, and then maybe you'd have. You could actually cut
long.
It in a. four.
It's gonna be pretty long.
It's one. It's one stocking, but it's enough to cover a whole family of four. Their entire legs. It comes bundled in.
Okay.
Yeah. It's so stupid. Oh. It's so stupid.
let's take a question for better than Ezra. We've got Seymour.
Hi.
Suddenly, Seymour, you got to unmute your mic. Yeah. Why don't you come forward, Seymour?
There he is. Come forward, Seymour.
There he is.
Hi. So.
Okay. Hello.
Have either of you seen Ghostbusters?
Better than Ezra? You mean the newest one?
Have ever?
No.
The newest one? Ghostbusters?
Oh, yeah. Are you kidding? I love the Ghostbusters.
Are you talking about the old... The old Ghostbusters?
Yes. Old Ghostbusters.
Hey, I ain't afraid of no ghost. Does that answer your question?
Yeah.
How about you?
That's good.
I ain't afraid of no ghost. Yeah. I ain't afraid of no ghost.
I'm not afraid of no ghost either. Oh, and the flowers are still standing. Huh? No?
Okay. Yep.
Okay, let's
wait, was he talking about the old animated
Ghostbusters.
Comic book Ghostbusters? The
old one? He's talking about the movies.
No, he's talking
about... No. Oh,
okay.
Movies.
Because, yes, the answer is yes, if that's...
Yeah, yes.
I love the Ghostbusters.
They're a good band of people, and I like them, and I like their converted... They were very scrappy, and they would convert hearses into... productive vehicles, so it was kind of cool. It was a good movie. The new Ghostbusters I haven't seen because I didn't want to be disappointed because I heard a lot of things, but I think it's probably pretty good. Let's take another question, this time from the farthest hand I can see in the distance, and that would be Tall!
Wedgie! Tall! Wedgie, what are you doing
your question?
Here, this is your mother!
Tall!
I told you to stop
my
hanging
God,
out!
Oh my goodness!
Like weirdo. He's too squashy.
She sounds so African. That's too squashy.
She's right.
That's a reference.
She's right, Reggie. She's right.
Sorry, Mom. I'm sorry. Do you have a question?
I'm disappointed.
You're grounded.
She's just... oh, man. That is the weirdest Nigerian accent I've ever heard. Okay. What are you doing,
Tall?
Nigerian,
Reggie. Stop being racist.
I'm not... Hi. Hold on. Hey, do that again. I want to take a picture of you.
Get this squash fell off, Wedgie.
Oh shit! You got lower. Somehow
he's
you got
squashing all over me.
I don't even know if I can. I think I'm disabled. I can't take a picture.
He's squashing.
Okay.
It's funny.
Remember it.
Reggie, it's funny. There are hundreds of people out there that are disabled every day in their normal just life, and it's crazy to think just for a moment you were disabled, and isn't that crazy? Where it's like, oh my god,
actually,
I was disabled.
No, you're right. Yeah, I don't think of it that way.
It's
because I'm like, what don't I have? You know, I'm thinking of it in that way. I'm like, what's not working? But in fact, like some people, it's never gonna work. You know what I mean? They're going to have other things that are going to work better.
And it really puts things into perspective when you are in that kind of a situation, you know? Anyways, that's a pro-disabled conversation.
I want to take this question. Who's this guy? So, sorry to interrupt. I'm just seeing a local area network.
Hi.
Area network. Yeah, you're right. You got it.
Local area network.
Hi. Do you have a question?
It's reverse springtime now, and I just wanted to know if you guys prefer chili or stew.
Oh, stew. Although chili, yeah. I wish you could. Hey, let me see if I'm disabled. I'm not disabled. I'm still. You're making chili right now? Okay, maybe chili then for me.
I want chili. I would take stew though for holidays, but I'd also eat chili. Listen, you put it in front of my face, I'll eat it. You know what I mean?
I've seen your face eat stuff.
High five on that one. It doesn't matter what it is. Pennies, magnets, you put it in front of my mouth. You can't be sure I won't swallow it.
That's a face of an eater. That's a face of an eater.
Look at this face right here. Look at this eater face. Hello.
Look at that. Hey, let me get you something.
Yeah, give me something to eat. Let's go find something.
I'm gonna find something.
Find a snack.
Hey guys, let's go find something.
Let's go find a snack. I know there's gotta be.
Let's see.
Oh yeah, there's gotta be something in this graveyard here for sure, right?
Let's check it out.
I mean, you know, look who lies here. Batman.
Hey, yes. Justin, there's a person.
Pepsi. Oh wait, where is it?
Pepsi.
Where's?
Where? Oh, where are you?
Oh, hello, oh, Pepsi.
Hi, young lady. Hey, this is young lady hello. Pepsi.
Pepsi.
What the young lady?
Crystal Pepsi.
Yeah, motherfucker.
Yeah. Oh.
Yes.
Crystal Pepsi.
I like that you're kind of like the interpreter. It's like for those of you who are visually impaired.
Can you see everyone?
Hey, so if you're watching this, if you're watching this on a replay, just get in where Crystal and Pepsi are standing right now. If this is a replay, yeah. Come on.
Yeah.
Totally.
How are you, Brian?
I wish we were in a speedboat. Yeah, America. All right, cool.
Hey,
well, now
we're
here. We have the sales. Yeah, no. What were you gonna say?
Yeah. Oh, I was gonna say. Now that we're here, we should have our seance.
What did you say? Say it again.
I said, now that we're here, I think we better have our seance.
A seance, right. Okay, cool. All right, so let's, I guess we need, I'll start it off by, we need them facing north, south, and east, and west.
Okay, yeah.
Okay.
So let's see. Sorry. I have eight technicians messing with my sensors.
In the middle. This is our offering.
Yeah. Yeah. You guys put all these controllers here. It's gonna be the largest controller stack in history. Yeah, but
now what's important is that now, if we do this, if we do this for long enough, just all the way up to the tree, all the way up to the tree, please.
Oh, look at that! So beautiful. I wish we were
all the way up to the tree.
Look at the spinal column; it's amazing. It's a brachiosaurus column. Okay, guys, now we
all
just need to hit
the
same
tree.
Tone. We have to hit the same tone, so we're gonna, I'm gonna start the tone, and you guys just, like, start on the same tone. You guys ready? Okay, and I'm gonna say a quick incantation. Oh, great spirits of the virtual world, rise into the knowledge of tree underworldism. Please, hear our tone.
Ah. Did you guys feel that? Did you guys feel that?
Is that a ghost?
Yeah. Our friend Seance showed up and went away really quick.
Oh, Seance?
Yeah.
I love Seance.
Seance.
Hey, check this out. I can make this controller levitate. Watch this. If I put this over here.
Whoa.
Oh, yeah. Damn it, I lost my car. Sorry. I'll try it one more time. Okay. Okay. Shit. Okay, now I'm gonna try to put it in my hand.
Whoa!
There it is.
Whoa!
Oh, damn it. Fuck! Man, you better try something. Oh yeah, can you help me up?
Yeah, here we go.
There's actually a real hand. That was what was really weird. There's actually a real hand. That was very weird. I was like, hey, can you help me up?
Should we
hand? Yeah.
Should we go?
What should we do?
Reggie, look at that weird ghostly. Yeah. Look at that weird ghostly blue character over there. Let's go. What are we dealing with here? We've got.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Whoa, we got a ghostly character here in the back.
Oh,
this ghostly who's character.
Who's that?
Catherine.
Oh, Catherine. Oh, whoa. Catherine. Catherine, what's going on? Unmute
the
yourself.
Ghostly spirit.
Catherine. Catherine. Catherine.
I think it's Catherine. Cat herring.
Hey, Cat herring.
Come on, Cat herring. Speak up. Speak your mind, Cat.
We summon you. We summon you. Oh, shit. Oh, my God, Cat herring. She was just a ghost.
Oh, my God. Wait, is she in here?
Yeah, please do. Okay, I'm leaning in. Oh, there's nothing. There's nothing on the other side.
Whoa, there's people over there.
What happened to Catherine?
Whoa.
Somebody's house.
Wait, is that? It's Catherine.
She ran.
Right here. She screamed over here.
Oh, she's over here, guys. Great, go get over here. Tell
it's
us your
ghost.
Story. What brings you to this world? What brings you to our world, Catherine?
What brings you to our mortal coil?
Catherine. Catherine, and so... She...
You could be Catherine if this is a replay.
Oh, she disappeared again!
Oh, no. No, she's here.
Whoa. Where is she now?
You okay now?
Oh, she's... What a crazy... What a ghost lady. Oh, wait a minute. Something's over here, guys.
Pepsi! Pepsi! Mary. Catherine! Oh, man.
Mary! Look at that. She's so still and perfect. And look at her tiny feet. They're so tiny. The tiniest feet in the world. The two golf clubs. Two golf club feet.
What?
Hi, Mary. What are those? 10 irons? Now, follow her. Follow Mary. There's something about her. Whoa. What's over here?
What's over there? What's over there, Reggie?
What is it? I can't quite get over. I can't. A group picture?
We gotta go get her.
Oh, shit. No!
Sarah,
I think I know how. I know how to get you out. Sarah, cars are blue. Oh my God, I didn't notice that it was steaming. Oh, that's crazy.
Rip
Sarah,
out.
I think you're gonna. Oh no. God,
rip
damn it,
out.
Justin.
Here.
Help! I drove wrong! I drove wrong!
God damn it!
I drove wrong!
Dustin, can you see my hand?
Yeah!
Can you see my hand?
I drove wrong!
But what about Sarah?
We did it.
Sarah getting... Oh, Sarah! Yay! Hey, Sarah. Hey, Sarah, you're going to have to replace your radiator. Hey, Sarah. Sarah, over here. Y'all going to have to replace your radiator. Okay?
Okay.
Whee! Y'all have to replace the right. Oh, what's she doing? Oh, thank you. I'll put this in my pocket.
Put it in your packet. All right.
Okay.
I'll get to all work right. Well, on it.
Yeah, get to work on it. I'm gonna go around the other side. Okay, here. What we got over here?
Well, it looks like her radiator's all wrong.
Yeah,
she's got three radiators.
Like oh shit! Well,
she's got three.
Are they all broken?
You only need one radiator. All three of them are one shot.
Oh,
what
shit.
Kind of mess have you gotten yourself? She got herself into a real doozy. This one.
Oh, well, God.
We're gonna have to call in Joey. Joey to fix it.
I'll give him a call right now. Hey, Joey. Hey, Joey, can y'all come down here with the AAA truck? Yeah. Okay. Yeah, there's a boulder in front of the road, but you can move it if you got a crane. Okay, cool. Hey, guys, he gonna be here soon. Joey. Oh, that's true. Listen to her. She does. What? Oh, he is? Can you have him come into this reality?
Oh.
Hey.
Oh.
Steep, isn't it?
Oh. It's very steep. It's slippery. Don't fall. It's slippery. Oops. Oopsies. Oopsies. Oopsies.
Whoa. Jesus Christ. Oh. Hey. Whoa. You okay?
Whoa.
Okay. Oh shit.
I'm all right. I got a real. That was a real one.
That was a real doozy.
Come on. Let's go rock climbing. I'm going rock climbing. I don't care what you say.
Okay, good luck.
I'm going
it's
up.
It's a steep hill.
See you all later up here.
Okay.
I'm going up to the TV
tower.
Oh,
that's good. That's good. Keep going. Hey, can anybody help him? Maybe give him a boost?
I think it's kind of screwed anyway.
Oh, shit. Okay, now we got... Oh, look, there's a big jab hand up there.
It's
a big hand.
I'm clicking it.
I don't know. I'm trying to get that piece of ham. Oh, that piece of ham disappeared. Oh, wait a minute. There it is again.
Oh.
Okay. No, it's not selected.
I can't.
Yeah, I know.
Can't.
What? Who's this? Bass Boone. Is that the mechanic?
Bass Boone.
Oh, Bass Boone. Unmute
what up,
yourself.
What up?
All right, Bass Boone, what you got?
Nothing really. Some
okay, see you later. Bye, Bass Boone.
Bass Boone.
Okay.
Bass Boone.
Bass Boone. Bass Boone.
I know that name. Bass Boone's a name I know.
Oh, we got Guest 190215. Who? Ghost?
Oh, shit.
Who?
Ghost Recon?
Holy shit!
Holy
fuck! God damn it! Ghost! What's wrong with you? Okay, alright. We're coming, peace.
You got a question, Ghost? Or are you just going to sink into the ground?
Nope. Okay. Well, see you later. Sheesh. How about guest 190215? Anybody? Guest 190215. Going once. Going twice. Going three times. And. Yeah, I know, but they don't even got a mute symbol. So I don't even think they got a microphone. Maybe they do.
I don't know. I
didn't design all the space.
Guess. Oh, there's Boba Fett.
Oh, there.
Am I in the zone?
That's Boba Fett.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Boba.
Hey, what's the word on Gloop World? Is that happening still?
Yeah, yes. I can't say anything officially, but it's moving along. It's moving along!
Yeah. Cool. Well, my brother's a stop-motion animator, and he told me about the project. Very excited.
Oh.
Yeah, but why is he against motion? Get rid of it! Get rid of it! Yeah.
I'm sick of this motion.
Project. Stop it! Okay.
You gotta stop the motion!
I'm trying to find it. Wait, how do you. Where did. How. Who. What. Hey, where's Catherine?
That's the girl over there.
Oh, there she is, Kath. Go get Catherine.
Catherine!
Go get her. Go get that Catherine.
Get her, she's coming. She's going.
Go get her. Y'all go get her.
She's going.
Get that poor Fran. Go get her. Where is she now?
She's going back to the stage area. She's going back to the stage area.
Oh, no,
she's playing
the pumpkin. Oh, no, look. Buzzy, what'd you do? Oh, Buzzy.
Buzzy?
Buzzy body. What a buzzy body. Okay, well, fuck it. Well, you know what? Well, let's just leave him up there. It's Halloween. Yeah, for next year. Yeah,
hit him with the hind. Next year. Let's hit him with the hind.
And look. Oh, hey, Tammy, be careful up there. Tammy, be careful. For those of you in alternate dimensions, there's a. Yeah. Oh, sorry. I thought it looked like an A. I'm sorry. Jesus.
For me.
Like it makes a difference. Okay.
Tommy.
All right. Well, let's, hey, Tommy.
Head
let's
back
go back
into
to
the...
this reality.
Yeah. I love the ambience out there.
Did that even happen?
Did
that even happen?
It was a nice creepy ambience out there. That was pretty nice. It's a nice little thing.
That's really nice,
guys. I
wanted
to say barn with the barn owls and everything. So,
God, this feels so
we
want to
thank everybody.
Yes, everyone.
So thank everybody for even especially let's do the credits list. Our favorite people. There was Pepsi.
You go first.
Who could forget? Pepsi. There was Crystal Pepsi. I guess they were together. They were a duo. Tommy, and Alec.
Alec.
There are so many. Sarah. There was guest 146325.
Yes. Thanks for correcting us on that one.
Yeah.
Oh, Catherine.
And then last,
Catherine.
My favorite.
Hey, we want to thank Alternative Space for providing another space that's different from the usual one. We want to thank the support teams here at our house, all 18 of you.
that are in each of our houses. I want to thank barn designers, the people who created this creepy world for you guys to hang out in. That's a big deal. It's really cool.
Yeah.
Big claps.
Yep.
Yep.
Yep. Let's see it.
I want to thank
that clap together.
Yeah, let's see. Yeah. Yeah, put them up.
Look
put
at these claps. Look at this clap.
Whoa.
Yeah. Oh,
wow. That's something.
That's a clap.
I'm just
doing
that.
You know you care. That's when you know you really care, y'all. When you clap like this, you can't clap.
Yep. I'm alligator.
You gotta
now.
Do the little clap. Clap.
Yep.
Clap. Clap.
Yep.
Clap.
Yep. Yep. Yeah, your hands are fancier than mine. I can't get them right. hey, we want to thank Swenson's Farm for providing all this hay. Also want to thank Swenson's
thank
Farm
you,
for these
Swenson.
Huge. Thank you, Swenson, for these huge pumpkins. It's hard to get these, and we got them just in time. So
when you
thank
need
you, Pumpkin
hay,
Master.
Call Swenson. That's their jingle they told us to do.
Bye, Swenson.
Pumpkins.
Bye, Swenson. Everybody, on 1, 2, 3, we're going to say bye, Swenson. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Bye, Swenson.
Bye, Swenson.
Good. Okay.
Nice
obligation
work.
Fulfilled.
That's as good as it.
So say...
Oh, yeah. Do we?
Oh, yeah. You just got to click on a pumpkin. Yeah, you just have to click on the pumpkin, one of Swenson's fine pumpkins here. Just click on it, and that will get you in to the official E-Trade Commerce stock business officially. So that's all it takes. And give yourself a round of applause if you did it, because that just means you bought a whole bunch of stock for free. Give a round of applause here.
Yeah.
Bye, Swenson.
Bye, Swenson.
Bye, Swenson.
Bye, Swenson. I'm kicking chairs.
Come on.
I'm stuck in my chair. Hold on.
Oh man, whoa.
Hold on.
Whoa.
Hey, whoa. Hold on. Okay, here we go. Here we go. It's what I always want to do. Stiff as a feather. Stiff as a board.
Here we go, ready?
Yeah.
Here we go.
Oh shit.
No. Go.
Hey,
go.
Sorry,
go.
Man.
Sorry.
Hi. Hey. Hey, Justin, you're taking big steps. Hey, Justin, where are you? Justin. Hey, Justin. Justin.
Yeah.
Where are you? Hey, Justin. Where are you? Okay. Hey, guys. Okay. I don't even know how I'm...
oh, no, you got Sarah.
Okay. Uh-oh.
Whoa.
Okay.
Whoa.
Hey, guys.
Whoa.
I don't know what's going on.
Whoa.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Whoa.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
Whoa.
Okay. All right.
Whoa.
Whoa. Okay. Well, that about does it for our show today. That's pretty good. Hey!
Somebody get a picture of it! Hey, thanks. Oh, God.
All right, let's do it. Oh. I actually kind of like this. Yeah, where would you guys like to go?
Yeah.
The graveyard or
Scarecrow?
Scarecrow! Go Scarecrow. Go to Scarecrow mode. Oh, guys, there's Hangy McHangerson.
Take advantage of this. Taking advantage of my leg being out like this.
Okay, here we go.
Yes, thank you.
Did you get the camera?
Yeah.
Who's taking the picture? Is it Lisa?
Hey, Lisa? Check me out. Check me out, yo.
Lisa, Lisa, do you have the are you using a DSLR or are you using your phone? Lisa. Okay. Well, I'm just saying, like, you might as well, if you have a DSLR, use that. Okay. I don't see the DSLR. Okay. Okay, I see. I didn't hear the sound.
I didn't hear a click.
Hold on a second.
Oh my God.
Hold on, it's gonna get better, Ben, guys. It's about to get a whole lot better. All right, hold on. Okay, okay, hold on.
This is gonna be great.
All right, this is gonna be some good shit, yo. Yeah. Hey, y'all. Hey, I've got a sensor. It's coming off. Hold on. I'm putting this back. I don't know where it's going. I'm Irish. All right.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, wait a minute. I wonder what'll happen. What if... Hold on. Yeah, just like let it fall to the floor. This is gonna be so terrible.
Oh wait, are you doing what I'm thinking you're doing?
Yeah, guys... I think so. Hold on. Hold on, okay.
Will you guys start dismantling my
Yeah, exactly. This is our dismount.
Yeah, this is the dismount. I'm gonna hold very still.
How do I look? I look cool? Yeah. Man, this feels so good. This feels like me more. Yeah, I mean, I do love this leg right here. That's just cool. You don't get that anywhere.
Except look, for an alt look, space. Look. Look at me. Look at me. Oh, sorry. Oh, jeez.
Yeah, totally. That's awesome.
Oh my god.
Someone take a picture. Oh god. Justin, you okay? Justin.
No.
Oh no. What's going on?
No.
Oh, Jesus.
No.
Oh god, what's happening with your hand? Oh no.
No.
Oh god. This is terrible. No. Guys, no. You're not meant to see this. You really. Oh no. Oh my god. Oh my god. Justin. No. Justin.
No.
No.
No. No. No.
No. I don't think I'm frozen. Yeah. Woo. USA. USA. Guys, this is the best that Silicon Valley has to offer, guys. Get a load of it. This is called floating pretzel.
Give it a few more years, and then you'll really see floating pretzel.
Hidden boyfriend. Okay. All right.
All right.
Okay, y'all.
Thank you, guys.
Okay.
Thank you, guys.
You guys.
We're gonna leave now.
You guys are the best.
Thank you so much.
I love you. Yay! Thank you. Thank
Bye.
You. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Oh my god. Oh shit.
I'm going to sleep. Bye. A letter.
Lisa. I have to work in 7 hours, so I'm going to bed.
Yeah.